Today's video is all about the bag valve mask. Welcome back, my name is Tammy and this is Nurse Minder, and on this channel we do everything nursing. So if you're new here, consider subscribing below so that you get the next video when it's released. Supporting a patient's airway during a respiratory crisis will require the use of an airway device. And so you can certainly use your own mouth-to-mouth respiration, providing it is safe to do so. There's also your own personal CPR mask that looks a lot like this with a valve. But today's video, we're talking about the bag valve mask. Now the bag valve mask gets its name because of what it represents. There's a bag, there's a valve, and there's a mask. Now maybe you know this by other names. BVM is common, bagger is common. Put it in the comments below, because I'm sure with our international audience, we're probably going to learn a few things about what others call this particular respiratory aid. Now this does come with a port for oxygen. First, you should know that this would be attached to oxygen, whether it's a canister or on the wall. And then what happens is this bag fills up and it becomes a reservoir. This bag is full of oxygen and is a reservoir. And when we put the mask on the patient's face, it creates a closed system so that when we press on the bag, the patient gets great oxygen delivery. Now the part that we don't often talk about in our CPR classes and our training is, what does this valve actually do? And this is a fascinating piece of our equipment that we often don't think about. However, if you've ever been to your bedside and you see a little bag full of colored attachments, they're light pink and yellow and I think blue maybe, it's been a while since I've seen them, you can actually put one of those pieces on here, and what that dials up is the amount of pressure that we keep in the lungs when they exhale. So we call that PEEP, positive end expiration pressure. And as you and I are breathing right now, we also have positive end expiration pressure, and it's a positive value. Usually about 5 of PEEP is what we call it. But as somebody is sick and potentially their belly is filling up with fluid, or they have a lot of edema, or there's blood around the lungs and it's squeezing them tighter and tighter and tighter, what happens is those alveolar air sacs start to collapse because the fluid has a higher pressure than the air does coming in. And so our normal PEEP of 5 is not enough to prevent the fluid from closing those alveolar sacs in our lungs. So what this valve does is it actually dials up the amount of PEEP. So we can dial up 10 of PEEP, 15 of PEEP. And so when the patient goes to exhale, it will keep a particular level of pressure inside the lungs to make sure that we keep those alveoli sacs recruited so we can have gas exchange. Now when it comes to securing this device, you'll note that there is a triangular shape to the mask. So the tip goes over the bridge of the nose and the bottom sits just underneath the lip in the chin. So we're going to put that on here. And then the way you want to seal is you take your hand and you make a C. So your thumb and index finger can make a C, and you're going to come up nice and tight to the mask, pressing down, rotating your hand so you can get those fingers under the chin to lift it up to the sky. Now this is an important element because this is going to take the tongue off the back of your throat. And then you're going to depress about 1/3 of that mask until you see the lungs start to rise. So once again, standing at the head of the patient's bed, you're going to take your bag valve mask, take the tip over the nose, secure that down. Now I use my dominant hand inside the loop here, and this will pivot all the way around so you can find a comfortable position. And then to seal this, you're going to come in tight. Don't be shy, come straight up to the center. Push straight down first. Move your fingers so you can get them under the chin and lift the chin to the sky, and then give your breath. Now some of the common mistakes I see is that when people come on here, they try to keep their fingers wide. And what happens is you can already see that as I'm putting downward pressure, my mask is tilting. And then as I go to give my air, the air will come out. The air will seep out of this side because it is not a tight seal. And it's actually really awkward. You can see it's lifted off the mannequin here. It's really awkward to do that hold. Now, when it comes to how many breaths do you give, if you are the one assisting in CPR, somebody's doing compressions, and your role is airway, You will do two breaths after every 30 compressions if the patient is not intubated. And if the patient is intubated, you'll give one breath every 5 to 6 seconds while they are doing compressions, and you'll try to coordinate on the upstroke. So as they're coming up, you're giving breath. Now, I often see when people are first working with these, it's their very first time, that when they go to squeeze it, they feel like they need to squeeze it completely. And that is actually not the case, because if you squeeze it all the way so that the edges are touching on the inside, you've given them too much oxygen, or too much volume of oxygen. So what happens is you get air going into the lungs and into the stomach, because remember, this patient is not capable of managing their airway, and the little flap, you know, here that directs food into the stomach and air into the lungs, well, this is also not working properly. So you're going to get air into the stomach, which then means if you give too much volume or too many breaths, which I have done, you will then create a situation where your patient might vomit. And that is not a good situation, because they're at real risk then of an aspiration pneumonia. And listen, guys, they're already coming back from the dead. That's a big enough thing to recover from. We don't want to add a pneumonia on top of that. So that's it. Short, sweet, to the point, using your bag valve mask. Make sure you comment below and let me know, what do you guys call it? I'd love to know what my international audience, how they talk about this, how they describe it, what they would say if they were calling a code. Hey, you, go get a. I want to know what you say. So drop your comments below, let me know, and don't forget to buy your Nurse Minder merch. You can help me here on this channel continue to provide this content by supporting me through buying either the Nurse Minder merchandise, which you can see on this YouTube station, and of course, liking, comment, and sharing these videos with your friends, subscribing if you haven't already, all helps with the YouTube algorithm to continue to spread this content to other people like you who are looking just for this. We'll see you next time. Don't forget to make it a great day.